This one I have checked it, it's gonna be in sync. Okay, I didn't mean to freak out everybody on that last one of the T cells and the thymus, but it is true what they've been saying, that the 65 point, there's a cutoff and the thymus is no longer producing these T cells. Now whether it produces them, but then they're no longer available for immunity. It might do that, I'm not sure, but apparently the immunity is broken. It cuts off at that point. And so then we're susceptible to colds and flus and all these things, you know, and so then we start to become, you know, a little bit of wind happens and we die, and something like that. So that was really what that last video was about. But I don't know. I just could not stand that it wasn't in sync, so I had to now make it in sync, and then here is really the gist of it in a hurry. Because yeah, I mean, and the happiness of it, the happiness in the thymus, apparently the thymus is important for serotonin release. It's the one that makes all kinds of, you know, our intestines are responsible also for the thymus working properly and releasing the T cells, which also in turn release our happiness to these endorphin uppers. You have the one that's going through well, and it's almost like when your digestion is going through properly, then it releases that message through to your thymus, which is in your collar bones, and then it heads straight up into the brain, and then you get like a rush of yes. So it's almost like as the food is passing through your intestine and it's given the A-okay, I'm happy with that you gave me. And then it goes drum. I am not kidding, and that's as simple as that. Now the drama is when we're 65, or you know, the stayed number when apparently everything starts to fail, that that message machine to our happiness is not the same. So I'm not sure, you know, when I see old people that are like, you know, in full happiness, I'm not sure where it's coming from now. Maybe medication. Yeah, possible. But yeah, so that's interesting. So let's think about that. The intestine, the thymus, the happy brain. Very much that's it. So what you feed your intestine, you know, if it's happy with what you fed it, you will end up with the reward. Okay. So I find this reward happens happier with the raw. If you go with the raw. The raw vegan style. But it's not easy. It's not an easy diet because you have to give up on many things that are like crunchy, like the chips and those types of things, unless you have a dehydrator. So it's not an easy diet to live with, you know, like for the rest of your life and maintain. But apparently it's something that your intestines are happier with because it's just less work. You know, you're making them work less. They don't have to go, it's all cooked food and there's nothing, no nutrients, and I don't know what to do with it. You know, it's dead food in my intestines. Yeah, that's what they're yelling. It's dead food. What do we do? Maybe they don't know. I mean, think about it. I don't know what to do with it. You know, there's no message given. No message given to the receptors. Yeah. Anyway. Always trying to solve our health, aren't we? Yeah. Okay. Receptors. Happy, happy.